Rovia, and I'm fortunate to be with Brother Eunice Sangare, who was reportedly attacked in Conakry, Guinea, by armed robbers. And I'm going to be speaking to him today, asking him exactly what happened. And I believe he's going to speak louder so you will understand exactly what happened. Brother Eunice, welcome to my microphone.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Bomba. Anyway, I would say Alhamdulillah, thank God, all praise to Allah. The very first day I arrived in Conakry, from the airport to my residence in Ratoma, it took me about 1 hour, let's say roughly 45 minutes, when the bandits and robbers went to my house, they attacked me. But, you know, fortunately for me, I survived the attack. Well, the rumors in Conakry, the attack that I underwent, I was the only person that survived the kind of attack. Okay, I was with my brother, Faligu. But as I'm speaking to you, I don't think his hand is going to be all right. But for me, I can say Alhamdulillah, I can shake my hand now. You know, as far as I'm concerned, everything is fine.
You are telling us that you were the only person that survived such an attack.
Yes.
Describe the attack and tell us why you think you were the only person that survived such an attack.
Yeah, because first of all, it's a kind of organized crime. They are at the airport to monitor people's activities. Okay, when you get out of the airport or the terminal to go home, they follow you at your residence. Okay, I think you remember one other guy came from Masanta, no, Philadelphia. But I can say the coin, his origin from Marseille, no farmer in Goa, I can say. He was killed, and another three full of
boys. All right, back to our interview. Brother Eunice, you just said that you were the only person that survived such an attack. And there were rumors in America saying that Eunice came back to Africa, and he had Guinean soldiers everywhere around him to protect him, and this might have motivated the armed robbers. What do you have to say about this?
Well, it's a complete false. There were no Guinean soldiers around me. You know, I was escorted by one of the commander of the Guinean armed forces, but he had no other bodyguard. Okay. So, I mean, that was a totally false rumor.
Now, before we wrap up, I want to ask you, you have a lot of friends over there who come back from the United States to come and visit this area, and people try to hunt them. So what would be your own advice to those people who want to visit Africa as a whole, not just Liberia or Guinea?
Well, I would tell everybody, just be careful. Just be normal, you know. Just be normal, be careful. Know who to talk to. Know who to move with, because you're not gonna be liked by everybody. Just know what you're doing. You know, just be careful. That's the bottom line.
So technically, if you're from Africa, do you have like an African? Is that what you mean?
We will never be like African. You know, no matter how you pull it, you can never be like those that we met here. You know, but just be normal, like any other person.
Thank you ever so much for speaking with me.
Okay.
And this is Brother Eunice Sangare speaking to Lasana Bamba in Monrovia, and specifically we are speaking to you from Water Street. Thank you ever so much for monitoring this interview. Thank you.